First of all, we do a short talk on something that I call Occam's razor versus Hickam's dictum, right? How many of you are already aware of these two terms? Good, so this will be something new for you. Occam's razor and Hickam's dictum has already been spoken about by Dr. Ambedkar, and I'll be just giving it names. Occam's razor is a heuristic. Heuristic. What is a heuristic? Heuristic, H-E-U-R-I-S-T-I-C. Heuristic is a shortcut. It's a mental shortcut to make things easier, if not perfect. So when Dr. Ambedkar gave you those five things in a patient of fever, those five things comprised a mental shortcut, which may not give you the perfect answer, but will lead you somewhere close to it. That is a heuristic. So Occam's razor is a heuristic. Can we come to the next slide, please? It is also known as the law of parsimony. Do you know the meaning of the word parsimony? Miserliness, conjusi. That is parsimony. Okay? We'll come to why is it called the law of parsimony. The Occam's razor. William of Occam was a 14th century philosopher. He used this dictum in philosophy, theology. This dictum is used in science, is used in astronomy and many other sciences. It's used in psychiatry and psychology. We are using it in symptomatology. Among competing hypotheses, the one with the fewest assumptions should be selected. That is Occam's razor. Therefore, if the patient comes with fever, abdominal pain, and burning in the urine, one assumption will satisfy all three symptoms. What is that? UTI. So how many assumptions? Have we made three assumptions that this is malaria with appendicitis, with urethritis? No, we have made one assumption. That is called Occam's razor. Make few diagnosis from multiple symptoms. Next slide, please. We switch it to diagnostics, symptomatology. So we've created this law of diagnostic parsimony. Conjusi when you're making a diagnosis. Try to explain all the presenting symptoms with one unifying diagnosis. If you can do that, that is applying the Occam's razor. Is it always going to be correct? No. So it's not perfection that you are going to achieve. It's just a mental shortcut. We use the Occam's razor day in and day out in our practice without knowing the name of Occam's razor. We use it every day, right? Okay, next slide, please. Now this is Hickam's dictum, a counter argument to Occam's razor. Patients can have as many diseases as they damn well please. So if the patient complains of knee pain and fever, he may have reactive arthritis or he may have osteoarthritis of the knee and malaria. The Hickam's dictum says all the symptoms can have different diagnosis. So that is Hickam's dictum. Our whole history taking, while we take the history, will make us mentally filter whether we want to use the Hickam's dictum or the Occam's razor. This you are already doing day in and day out. Next slide, please. So the Occam's razor will work when the patient has acute presentation, like fever or chest pain. Patient says he has chest pain and he has vomiting and he has perspiration and he has left-sided arm pain. Acute presentation. You will probably use not the Hickam's dictum but the Occam's razor. Correct? Would you agree that? When the patient is young, the Occam's razor works better than when the patient is a geriatric patient. As Dr. Ambedkar said, as you grow older, you become adulterated. So geriatric patients are the most adulterated of patients. They have multiple diseases. They are on multiple drugs which can cause multiple side effects. And hence a patient who's old can have multiple symptoms which are due to different causes. So Occam's razor will work better in young patients. And the most important thing that we already know is when all the multiple complaints start together, then Occam's razor will be the one to be applied. So fever with rigors, with dysuria, with flank pain, all occurring together will mean pyelonephritis. But if there is fever since 10 days, cough and cold since 2 days, you will not say the fever is viral URTI. You will look for other causes of fever, which is in 7 days. The onset was not with cough and cold. So you will know when to apply the Occam's razor and when to apply the Hickam's dictum. Next slide, please. So Occam's razor causes more errors when the patient is elderly, when the patient is on multiple medications, because side effects of medications are huge, and when the multiple symptoms are temporally disconnected. Timing wise, they occur at different times. Next slide, please. Okay, so now I end with this. If you are currently, all of you, one of you is presently tired, has a headache and some numbness in the right leg, the Occam's razor says that the symposium is the cause, while Hickam's dictum says that you have B12 deficiency, migraine and lumbar disc prolapse. You should know which to apply. Thank you. Thank you.